efforts are being stymied by the French.
I heard it said that they are quiet.
Still peaceful around here. No criminals, no French. What I wouldn't give for a good war.
Don't say such nonsense. Snails.
Maybe we can get some time.
No French.
Ah, Master Cormac. What you have learned from Le Chasseur was confirmed. The local lawbreakers are changing tactics.
What's their plan now?
Their boss has hired Benjamin Franklin to produce new weapons for them. He's very well guarded.
Benjamin Franklin? The scientist?
You have heard of him. Good. He is making equipment to spread gases among the populace. Toxic ones, as it turns out.
The populace? I thought they would use it against the authorities. Though that would be terrible as well.
The ruffians we have arrested refer to an intimidating woman. I believe she is behind these nefarious plans.
I look into this.
Thank you.
Hope. I pray it's not you.
You! I'm not getting paid for this. I'm done.
You there! Stop now!
Boy, you will not slip away. Come back here right now!
It will take more than that to lose me.
You foolish cur.
Shay, it is good to see you again. Your friend Hope said you were away.
I was. Sir, I've come to collect the results of your experiments.
Oh, well, it's a very good thing, then. I just finished fixing the prototype. Here you go. I was preparing to leave for Philadelphia, and then Europe. I was invited to lecture in London. Oh, would you be so kind as to inform Mistress Hope?
Of course. God, Hope. What are you doing with these felons? Turning the city against itself. What have you become?
Something the matter, Master Cormac?
No. Yes, just old memories.
When I am issued new recruits burdened with regrets, I tell them the surest way to lose them is with gunpowder.
You're right, Colonel.
This proto seems very powerful. Use it with care, Master Cormac. Our intelligence says this thing can destroy certain fortifications, as well as injure several enemies at once. There is also a more subtle way to use it. Some of these grenades contain a strong sedative. Fire one into the crowd and they will fall asleep immediately. We should test this new weapon. Use it against that door. Go ahead, Master Cormac. Shoot the door. Good work. Good work. I think you are ready to turn this door against the ruffians who have used it. There is an abandoned factory nearby hiding dangerous poison. Right now, it only causes sleep. But I fear those outlaws are distilling it. A more powerful formula could sicken or perhaps even kill most of them.
Then that's my first target.
Be careful.
understand that the Greeks are highly enslaved.
All the better.
Food for the change.
Nothing to interest you here.
General, need it. My family's in.
Stay away! This is dangerous!
We will burn down.
You can't do this! Guards! Guards! Somebody summoned a watch! Now!
pay for this! This is dangerous!
I can hit him from this.
You fool!
This is dangerous!
Are you crazy?
I have him in my sights. Fleeing is futile. You're on our territory, sir.
You there! Come over here!
Lost sight of him! We have to find him again!
Okay.
must get out, or I'm as good as dead.
He won't get past me! Yeah!
There is no way he will die.
What marvelous destruction, Captain. I saw the smoke all the way from the Morrigan.
That should discourage those miscreants. New York is safe for now.
With all due respect, Colonel, it's going to take more than a few explosions to get rid of this kind of trouble.
The boy is right, Colonel Monroe.
Shay, was it? Congratulations. We just burned a whole lot of rats out of New York. I'm Jack Weeks. This is William Johnson. I don't know about him, but I'm pleased to meet you.
To meet you as well.
It is terribly dusty here. I'm sure Shay can recount his adventures to us over a pint. Hey, the first round's on the Colonel.
Is something the matter, Master Cormac?
Just a little confused. I must have breathed some of that gas.
Some ale will do you good. Come, we are all friends here. You will be taken care of.
From the Colonel.
Dear Master Cormac, my apologies for the brevity of this missive, but it is time we were honest with one another. You have demonstrated your loyalty and resourcefulness to the Templar cause, and this despite and perhaps because of your assassin origins. The manuscript the assassin sought has been in my possession for some time. I reclaimed it when my men found you marooned. The Grandmaster himself charged me to discover its meaning, a task I regret I have failed to complete. I leave it in your charge, Master Cormac. There is no one else I trust more. Now I leave for Fort William Henry, an ill-prepared garrison surrounded by hostile natives and the French army. We have requested reinforcements, but I doubt they will be forthcoming. I have no illusions that our resistance will be successful. I commit my life to the British Army, and my soul to the Father of Understanding. Yours, Colonel George Monroe.
Man has the helm!
Mind your post, guest. The Colonel's in trouble.
How do you mean, in trouble?
He's at Fort William Henry, facing impossible odds.
Get off your lazy asses, lads, and man your stations! We raise anchor!
Sorry for the early libation, Captain. But do you realize that it's been a whole year since we met? A whole year! Changed my life, you did. And for the better. You will, forgive me if I have been celebrating without you.
A whole year. Guest, I have a question for you. How long have you known of my, well, former allegiance?
Oh, you mean the assassins? I knew that ages ago, Shay. I may be drunk, but I'm not blind. Or did you think I would assume you had escaped from some homicidal circus?
Why didn't you say anything?
Well, the Colonel wanted us to avoid the subject so it wouldn't, you know, influence your decision-making. You saved my life out of pure selfless instinct and helped countless others besides. If it were up to me, I would have made you an official Templar months ago.
Who is it up to then? Monroe mentioned a Grandmaster.
Watch out, bird!
Ready to fire, sir!
Damn it! It's jammed!
Fire! Surrender! Where's
the blasty pound?
Awaiting orders!
Fire!
Damn you!
Enemies fire!
The Grand Master of a colonial right. You'd like him, Shay. His father was an assassin.
It's a gunboat! Those ships belong to King Louis! They're all alone, sir!
They're firing a volley!
Hammond, it's that time!
Fire!
What is the news from Fort William Henry?
Garrison is surrounded, and reinforcements are late.
General Montcalm has been blazing a path across the colonies for King Louis, hasn't he?
I rather wish he'd stayed home with his mistress.
His or King Louis's?
Either, though I suspect the king's is finer.
Indeed. Madame O'Murphy is supposed to be quite the charmer.
And O'Murphy is in the French king's bed. Now I know you're pulling my...
With what we've taken, we can improve the ship, Captain.
We're
ready
gonna
for
hit
crash, them. Sir!
Is that button, lad?
So it's a cold and dreary morning in December.
Fire!
And
you heard the captain! Like a ghost.
Thank you.
floods and roils!
Hunters coming for us!
Let out some sail!
Helm!
say what you will about Braddock the...
Jesus Christ, again? What did I do to earn your scorn?
Please come in and cast an eye about. I'm your most... What can I do for you this day? Most excellent. Which of my treasures might tempt you today?
A pleasure.
Thank you.
of my treasures might tempt you today? My gratitude. Please come in and cast an eye about.
Our pleasure. See you next time.
Unfurled, mates!
Finish up!
Shit! Keep up the smoke, sir!
could be valuable cargo.
Hey, ships may come and ships may go as long as the seas do roll. But a sailor lad just like his dad, he loves the flowing bowl.
We're bearing down on those books, Captain! Door,
that's the rise of tops!
When your money's all gone,
drop anchor!
Open, lad.
Let the anchor go!